Hey there, Benjamin from LoveStarter here, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a funnel report in Google Analytics 4, GA4. If you've been using Google Analytics for a while, then you're probably already familiar with the funnel visualization report and goal flow report in Universal Analytics. These reports let you understand how people made it through specific steps before they converted, but the biggest drawback was that you had to configure them before data became available. Well, with GA4, that's all changed. You can create a funnel based on any historical data in your property. Let's head to Google Analytics to take a look. Okay, so I've already opened Google's GA4 demo property, and to start building our funnel report, we select Explore. And we're going to click Blank to start building our report from scratch. Let's name our report Conversion Funnel. And let's change the report from Freeform to Funnel Exploration. Now we look for steps and click the pencil icon to define the steps in our funnel. Today we're going to recreate a classic funnel based on the pages people view on the website, but you could use any of the events that are being collected into GA4 to define the steps. Let's name the first step, Billing and Shipping. And for the condition, let's search for and select Page Location. Then we click Add Filter. I'm going to leave Contains as the match type, but you can change this to Regular Expression for more advanced matching or any of the other options. Now we're going to enter yourinfo.html as the value. And click Apply. Now let's click Add Step. At the top of the second step, we can see it says Is Indirectly Followed By. You can select this and change it to Is Directly Followed By. For example, choosing this option would mean people won't be included in the funnel if they view another page in between steps. For my funnel, I don't mind if people view other pages or perform other actions, so I'm going to change this back to the default of Is Indirectly Followed By. And on the right, you can see there is an option to set a time limit, so the step needs to be viewed within a certain period of time. I'm going to leave this disabled. Now let's name the step Payment. And let's select Page Location as the condition. And we're going to add a filter. And enter payment.html. And click Apply. Now let's add another step. Let's name the step Review. Let's select Page Location. And enter reviewOrder.html. And click Apply. Now let's add one final step. Let's name it Checkout Complete. Select Page Location. Add a filter and enter OrderCompleted.html and click Apply. Now let's click Apply on the top right corner. We can now see the steps we've defined and the visualization at the top shows the number of users who make it through each step. Below the visualization, you can see the number of users who drop off at each step. And you can see a breakdown of metrics for the funnel in the table. You can customize your funnel report further. For example, you can enable the Make Open Funnel. This will mean users can enter the funnel at any step you've defined, rather than needing to travel through the first step. You can select Standard Funnel, and change this to Trended Funnel to see the trend for users based on the funnel step and the date range. You can choose a step at the top to then view the trend for each step in the funnel you've created. You can also apply segments to your funnel. To do this, you need to click the plus sign next to Segments and then choose a template or build your own segment from scratch. You can add additional details to the report by adding a breakdown dimension. To do this, you need to click the plus sign next to Dimensions. And then enable the dimension you want to use in the report. Let's search for and select Device Category. And click Apply. We can then drag this dimension to Breakdown. And the table now updates with metrics for each step broken down by the dimension. We can enable the Show Elapsed Time option to see the average amount of time it takes people to complete each step. And if you'd like to know what people do after they leave each step in the funnel, you can add a dimension as the next action. Let's add another dimension. Let's search for and enable page title and screen name. And click Apply. And let's drag this under Next Action. Now when we hover over each step in the funnel, we can see the top 5 pages people go to if they don't proceed to the next step. So that's how you can build your own funnel visualization report in GA4 and how you can begin customizing the report. Remember that we covered the steps to build a funnel based on the pages people view, but you can create your funnel using any of the events you've sent to your GA4 property. What type of funnel are you going to build in GA4? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below, and if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.